Hello, this is Marco and I work as a multimedia producer with the team of YouTrain project. This is the first video of our video manual on how to produce video tutorials for non-formal education. In this first video, we will focus on how to prepare everything for the shooting of our first video tutorial in a training context. We will give you our best advices, tips and tricks for the video production and how to prepare and plan everything so you won't face our same difficulties. To help you in the planning of your video tutorial shooting, we will present you some principles that we find out to be very useful to be more consistent and faster in the production and shooting of your own video tutorial. Principle 1. Before starting with the preparation of your first video tutorial, you should ask yourself, why and what? Why do you want to shoot this video tutorial? What is the topic that you want to focus on? And what is the message that you want to deliver? Maybe there are no other existing video tutorial on this method and you want to make the difference delivering it to your audience. Or maybe you have a project and you want to implement it with the use of video tutorials. Take some time to reflect on that, because when you know your aim, it will make a lot of difference. My advice is to start with defining and writing down these three elements: the aim, the subject and the target. The aim is why you want to shoot this video. What do you want to achieve? What's your goal? The subject is the topic that you will cover on this video. Can be an activity, can be a method, it's up to you. The target is the people and the audience who this video will be addressed to. Why these three elements are important? Because they will help you to have a clearer idea of what you're doing. What's the tone of voice to use? What's the kind of video that you want to produce? On principle 2, we focus on the video structure and the story it tells. We recommend that the video tutorial consists at least in the following blocks: an introduction, a main content, an ending, and possibly a call to action. The introduction is explaining more or less what's the video about. The main content, of course, it covers all the main message that you want to deliver. The ending is the closing of the video tutorial, and you can use it also to leave your contacts, to encourage people to follow your other videos or your social channels. And the call to action is engaging people to do a certain action. Can be the subscription, can be the participation to a specific event, it's up to you. And to be more engaging and easier to understand, also video tutorial needs to tell a story. Okay, so now we have our video structure and idea of the story. The principle 3 is to prepare the script. In the description of this video, you can find the template of the script we were using during our videos. The script is essential for both, for the trainer that will facilitate the activity and for the video team or the producer. How to make the script? The most efficient way is to use your training session outline as a base to create the script from. In the script, you need to describe with details two blocks. The first one is description of the method. In the template, you can see example questions that this part could be based on. This is effectively part of the narration and can be recorded before or after the facilitated activity in the most calm conditions. The second block is the session overview by video team. This is something like production notes. Here you describe the preparation, such as what location are used, how they are set up initially, what materials and infrastructure are required, what flip charts and outs or other resources you want to use. At the end, you have implementation. In this field, you describe point by point from beginning to the end what will happen in the activity follow blocks, such as minute and time, element blocks, group setup, location, interaction, possible movement of people and movement of the camera, and other observation that will be useful for the video team. For example, from minute 0 to 10, trainers give the instruction to the group and all participants are sitting down and trainers use flip charts. This could be a good example of what the implementation field can contain. After the script has been prepared, we move to principle 4, the details. For example, narrator or voiceover? Do you imagine your video led by a narrator that would be the trainer, or you prefer to record just the voiceover? The timing. How long do you want this video to last? What footage do you need to collect? Basing on the script, you prepare the shot list, which is just a description step by step of what you are going to shoot. Principle 5. Who and where? Are you the one who will film the video, or should you ask someone for help? Who is the trainer and who are the participants? Will you film during the training course, or you will organize a standalone filming? This is very important to schedule the shooting sessions and to know exactly who do you need, where and when. And finally, the principle 6. Take care of the participants. First of all, remember that filming an educational video tutorial cannot happen without participants that will be okay with it. In fact, it's important to ask them for the consent before filming. And if you are planning to film some method during a training course, you have to inform about it during the application process and then reinforce it during the selection. Describe the process a bit in the info pack and attach the claim form. Remember, they have to sign the paper to consent it. Secondly, after you have participants that agree to be part of the recording, help them to prepare. For example, you have to inform them about what colors or pattern of clothes not to wear, since that can affect the quality of the video. Or reassuring them that they should not act, but rather participating normally. And of course, no looks in the camera. And lastly, plan the group dynamics and program flow with big consideration of video making extra time required to set up the scenarios or to shoot again some footage that maybe are not so convincing. If you want to have more infos about production itself, you can watch the video too with the interview of one of the video makers and producer from YouTrain project. Thank you for watching this video. We hope that you will take the principle we share with you when you will be planning to shoot your own video tutorial. Please have in mind that what we presented here is our recommendation based on how we recorded the video tutorials in the Method Lab training course. If you are curious to check out the other videos, you can do it by clicking to the link in the description. And remember, you train, you learn.
YouTrain is co-funded by the Erasmus Plus program of the European Union. For more videos on non-formal education, please check out our channel and subscribe.